Shoot. Hey guys, I was going to take you for a ride today in my Dodge 392 Challenger SRT. That's street racing technologies. And this is my Challenger. I was just going to take the day off. We were going to go for a ride in the mountains, but as you can see, a snowstorm again. And she's not going anywhere today. We're not going anywhere, but I wanted to show you my car. And I'll give you a little tour of the old girl. This car's the car I'm driving when I'm not driving a Bronco or I'm not driving a Chevy. That's my go-fast car. It's my fun car. And she doesn't get driven a lot. I think I have 40,000 miles on it. It's a 2012. And I'll show you some features about this old girl that I like. For some reason, my video stopped. As you can see, the snow's melted, but I can show you the features now. One of my favorite features about this car is the stereo system. I've got a Harman Kardon stereo subsystem in here. That's my battery. It's a trunk mount battery on this car. You can see it's a nice car. I want to show you something on this car. You see that right there? There's a scratch right there. Someone tried to break into this car last night. See that right there? Someone tried to break into my car. Because that wasn't there yesterday. It's a scratch. Yeah. It's a 392 Hemi. That's a 6.7 liter, I think. 6.4 liter. Hemi. We went for a good ride today. Keyless entry. Anterior. You can see it's all black, red stripes. It's a nice car. Pop the hood. Show you the engine. And stripes. All right. 392. Nice engine. She's naturally aspirated. Naturally aspirated engine. And I don't have it supercharged yet or anything like that. But I may do that later. Car is fast, son. It's an SRT 392. SRT stands for Street Racing Technologies. It's got a track setting in there. As you can see, it's a 6-speed manual transmission. And this thing is fast, son. She's a fast car. Now, she's not a Corvette by any stretch of the means or stretch of the word, but she's fast. You see that? Catch that door action. The window pops down, it goes up in that channel. Watch this when I close it. That's pretty cool. Lock. She's locked up now. Aftermarket exhaust on the girl. Let you hear her run. For some reason, I filmed all this in the snow the other day, and it did not take any of the film. I must have had it on time lapse or something. She sounds really good. She is fast. Now I can set this, if we look at this, I can set this dash up. This will put it in system warnings, personal settings, temperature, elapsed time, surround sound, performance features. I usually just run it in the miles per hour. And I got sport mode. I'm going to push the sport mode button. Oh, the door's open. It's saying, close the door, man. Now it's in sport. And you can go through the sport settings too, just by up and down here. 0 to 60 times, 1/8 of a mile, 1/4 of a mile, braking distance, G forces, peak G forces. That's the last time I drove it, and I like to run it right there. Here you have a temperature setting, speedometer, and tachometer. Speedometer's on the left, tachometer's on the right. Fuel gauge. AC controls with automatic thermostat, so you can set it in auto. And you can set your temperature here for whatever you want it to be. Leave it in auto. Push button defrost. Heated seats. Anti-lock suspension. Turn that on for positive traction. And there we go. Heated steering wheel. Lighted cup holders. Now with that cup in there, I find it's in the way of the shifter. So when you drive this thing, it's best not to have anything in the cup holder, so you can grab that pistol grip shifter just like that. Fun car. Sounds great, drives great, scary fast. But that's how you start it. The keys never come out of your pocket. You just mash the clutch because it is a 6-speed. And then turn it off, you hit the power button. So this is one of my cars. It's not the convertible. It's not the old 49 I'm building, but it's a really nice car, and I enjoy this car. I don't drive this car every day. That is my daily driver right there. That is the honey badger of the automotive world, the Bronco. Bronco don't give a fuck. It's impervious to shopping carts because the Bronco don't give a fuck. Doesn't care if the roads are covered nice. Bronco don't give a fuck. It's really badass. Whereas this car is a little bit more refined and made solely for performance. Bronco don't give a fuck. Bronco does not give a fuck. 20-inch wheels all the way around it. We just went out on a ride, so she's a little dirty. But I'm saying that looks like somebody broke into it. Unless that was a piece of rock off the road. But see how it looks like? It looks like a screwdriver gouge. Like someone was trying to pry this open. I don't know. Maybe that's just my paranoia. But that 392, you have the Demon. You have the Hellcat. You have the 392. And then you have the RT. So this one is right there in the top three performance cars Dodge makes. This thing's got 175 horses, 175 foot-pounds, 475 horses, 475 foot-pounds of torque. I've got the aftermarket exhaust on there with the muffler deletes. So cat back is pretty much clean. Well, that's my other car. Let's take it for a ride. Okay, guys, we're back in the car. Leaving the come and go. There we go. We'll be right back. car drives really good through the pass, and you're only seeing me here drive a little bit on a flat road, but she's got all the performance that you'd ever need. It's a really impressive car.